You know, there are things in life that people talk about in strange terms. They say, yeah, that'll happen when pigs fly, or when the cows come home, or when a certain place might freeze over. And as strange as this introduction may sound, we do have one of these things to talk about today in reference to the cloud, and that is creating trusts between our on-premise domain and Azure Active Directory domain services. I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy. This is an exciting and unexpected video because the Azure AD domain services model was always set up as a managed domain controller in the cloud that just functioned as a domain as a service. So it wasn't something that you could ever manage. You didn't really have any rights inside the domain. And this move to make Azure AD domain services something that is more accessible to on-prem environments is really the direct result of your feedback and helping us to constantly improve products in Azure. So this video in particular came to my attention because it was requested by one of the members of our community. So thank you for that. And this is also a call to action. If you have anything that you're interested in that we don't currently have, please let me know and we'll be happy to create that for you. First thing that we should do is we should set a framework for why this actually exists going against the original model. So let's take a look at the Azure docs. So on our docs page, we'll go to products, and on the left, we'll go down to identity, and then Active Directory for Domain Services. And over in the left, under tutorials, we'll go to create a forest trust. So the basic use case here is if you're familiar with the Red Forest concept or tier 0, tier 1, tier 2 concepts, these are basically ways to set out your directory structures so that you can have layers of protection. Now, in these high secure or highly dispersed environments, sometimes customers do not want to have a tool like Azure AD Connect sending data out of their trusted tier 0 to the public cloud. And in those cases, then you're obviously not doing password hash sync or password write back. And it's also common to see that there are smart cards or MFA devices like RSA tokens or USB keys that are in those environments to control those privileged access workstations to be able to get into those tier zero assets. And part of that Red Forest type design is where we set up a resource forest. What is a resource forest? Well, basically it's where we can do identity pass through because of our trust, as you can see in the picture here, but the identities themselves only reside in the on-prem domain. And so when a user authenticates, their authentication will hit Azure AD domain services and redirect over the trust back to on-prem. So this is in lieu of those Azure AD Connect features. So a nice thing about this as well, especially if you're migrating to the cloud, is this means that you do not have to change everything about your application as you do the move. If you have domain controllers still on-prem and nothing in the cloud, then you can set up AD domain services with this trust, and then you can move those applications one component at a time. And then the last thing that we should mention up front is what exactly is a trust? A trust is a relationship between two domains or two forests. And these trusts can be in several different manners. They can be one way or two way, which one way is this object trusts this object. A two-way trust would be that they trust each other. And then there is transitive and non-transitive. And so this particular relationship is non-transitive, but a transitive relationship would be when I trust you, I trust everyone you trust. So in this case, this is non-transitive because we're only trusting from Azure AD Domain Services back to your primary Active Directory that we are establishing the trust with. So if there are any other trusts from your AD to somewhere else, we will not be trusting them. You'd have to set up separate trusts for each of those. We're going to do a five-step process today, and first thing is we'll be deploying Azure AD Domain Services, then we'll be configuring our on-prem AD in order to be able to forward requests, then setting up the inbound trust on our on-prem AD side, setting up the outbound trust on AD Domain Services, and then doing some testing to make sure everything works as expected. Let's jump over to the Azure portal. So the first thing we need to do is set up our Azure AD Domain Services. So I've got that up at the top here. We need to hit create. And in order for you to be able to do this, you do need to be a global administrator within Azure Active Directory. So I'll put this in a resource group that I already have set up. And then we have to give our domain a name. And then at the bottom, we select what location we want to deploy in. And we have the choice now of a forest type. So we'll be changing from user to resource. And that is going to set up our trust abilities. And we'll hit next for the network. And I've already got a network set up for this. And then hit next here for the administration side. And we'll leave the settings here as default, which will give our global admins rights inside Azure AD domain services. And we'll hit next. And now we have the synchronization, and here we can choose scoped or all. If we choose scoped, then we'll have to select a group, and that group will be the group that we synchronize over. So by default, we have Azure AD DC administrators. These are the admins of the Azure AD domain service. And we can also add other groups. For example, I could add my admins, or I could also add my WVD users. So I could add any groups that I want, and then they would be synchronized over. But in this case, I'm just going to select all and then hit review and create. And it validates that everything is okay. And then we push create. And because this is a one-time event, we're getting a extra warning here to make sure that we've done everything exactly as we want it. Because once we do, we will not be able to change it. You'd have to delete and throw away Azure AD domain services and start again. But I'm okay with everything, so I'll hit okay. Now, this deployment of Azure AD domain services takes about 20 to 40 minutes. So in the meantime, we need to set up a domain controller. At the top here, we'll type deploy, and we'll go to deploy a custom template. And at the load a GitHub quick start template at the bottom, we're going to type the word domain, and we'll select Active Directory new domain, and then hit select template. And we'll create a new resource group for this. And we'll put this in the East US as well. And then we need to give our basic information here. And then we check the box at the bottom and click purchase. And now that deployment is in progress, and this will take about 10 minutes as well. Azure AD Domain Services has completed building, and we can see it's currently running. And we have right in the center the ability to create a trust, which we'll come back to that in a moment. So let's go check out our domain controller that we also set up. And we can see that we have an availability set along with a OS and data disk, a load balancer, one network card, one public IP, one virtual machine, and we also got a virtual network created. So in order to make this network able to talk to Azure AD domain services, instead of having a VPN or ExpressRoute kind of connection, I've set up VNet peering, and the peering basically allows both networks to talk to each other in both directions. And back in the resource groups, let's look at the resource group where AD domain services actually lives. Now, this looks very similar to the domain controller buildout that we just looked at, because Azure AD domain services is basically a managed domain controller instance in the cloud. Inside this instance, there are two VMs. Each one has their own NIC. They're tied to a load balancer with an NSG and a public IP address on a network. Now, getting to our trust, first thing we need to do is set up some DNS settings on our domain controller. And for that, we're going to need the private IP addresses of our two VMs, which we can get either from going to our virtual network and seeing what IP addresses we've gotten to our devices, or we can find that in Azure AD domain services under properties, and we can see them right there as well. So I'll just copy those. Let's go to our on-prem domain controller. So I've already logged in and opened the DNS manager, which is installed by default when you make the system a domain controller. What we're going to do is set up a forwarder. So I'm going to right click on the server and go to properties. Then we'll go to the forwarders tab and hit edit. And then we'll type in our IP address here. And those have validated, even though it cannot resolve the DNS name. We'll hit OK and we'll apply and hit OK there as well. So now when a DNS request comes in that this server is unaware of how to resolve it, it will have somewhere to forward those requests into Azure AD domain services. And what we need to do next is start domains and trusts, and we'll right click on our domain and go to properties here, and we'll go to the trusts tab, and then we'll click the new trust button. And we'll need to add the DNS name for the forest that we're going to talk to, and we can find that back in Azure. So we'll just copy the name of our ADDS instance, And then we'll hit next. And this is going to be a forest trust. And then this is going to be one way incoming because the ADDS instance is going to send requests to our internal domain. And then we'll hit next. And this will be created for this domain only. We'll hit next. And then we need to set up a password for this trust. And then we'll hit next. And we've got our review here, and we can see our domain name from AD Domain Services, that this is an incoming trust. It is a forest type trust. And then our outgoing authentication level is forest wide as well. We can hit next, and we can hit next now to configure the new trust. And we'll click yes to configure the new trust now. And we need to type in the user who has permissions in the ADDS domain. And then we can click next and then click finish. So our trust on this side has been done. And now in order to complete the connection, we need to do the ADDS side. So let's go there. Okay, and in Azure, we'll go to our ADDS instance and click the create trusts. And we have a warning here at the top that we cannot do this part until we've created the outbound trust on our on-prem, which we have just finished. So we'll click add here. And then we need to give our trust a name, and we need to enter the name of our forest on-prem and the password that we set up. And then we need the IP addresses of our DNS servers on-prem as well. And then we can click save at the top. So that finished in about 2 minutes. And then you can see at the bottom here what domain we are connecting to and the DNS information that we entered. So we're going to now go into our on-prem domain controller and then see how we can leverage this resource forest that now we have a trust with. This is a server ADVM, and the domain is onprem.msazureacademy.com. And you can see up here in the command prompt, I'm logged in with my local admin user, and that is a member of this local domain. So now I've got another VM that I've stood up in Azure, and this VM is joined to the Azure AD Domain Services domain, and it's just called testtrustvm.aadds.msazureacademy.com. However, when I do my command to see who I am, and you can do that with who am I /FQDN, and I push enter, you can see that I am that same user from the on-premise domain, even though the VM itself is part of the Azure AD Domain Services domain. So that's the nature of a resource forest. Now, what can we do with this? Well, we can get access back to all of our on-prem resources that this user has access to. For example, here are a series of shares that are open, and we go into IT here, and we can see a bunch of different programs that we could install and scripts. For example, we could open this PowerShell file, and then we could run this script if we want to, or we could run this JSON file and open that in Notepad. So we can access file shares, we can access printer services, and then we can also do things leveraging our security groups across domains as well. So here in our VM that's joined to the Azure AD Domain Services domain, we've created a share folder on the C drive. And in here, we've created another folder, and this is called the No Trust Share. And if I look at properties under sharing, we can see under the permissions that this is shared with my temp user. If we go back to our on-prem, we can see that folder from that VM as well. But when we try to access it, we only get basically read-only access. We can't create any kind of files here because we don't have any permissions. How can we make something like this work across this resource trust? And we'll create for ourselves inside this Azure AD Domain Services Active Directory. We'll create a new OU, and we'll call this local objects and hit OK. And inside here, we'll create a new group, and we'll call this file server access, and we'll change our scope to domain local. And inside that group, we'll go to add some members. And you can see by default, we can see only the domain that we are a part of, but we can change our location to our on-prem that we are trusted with. And we'll hit advanced here and find now, and it wants us to provide our credentials for the on-prem domain. And we can see at the bottom all of our users from that trusted on-prem domain. We're going to just add all domain users just to make it easy and hit OK, and we'll apply and OK that. So now we'll go and set up a new share here, and we'll call this cross forest share, and then we'll go to the properties here. Then we'll go to the security tab and we'll push the edit button. Then we'll add our local group for the file server access and hit OK. And we'll allow modify here and we'll hit apply and OK. And then we'll go to the sharing tab. We'll share and then permissions here. And then we'll select change permissions for this and we'll hit apply and OK on all these windows. And back on our on-prem system, we'll hit refresh. And there is our cross-forest share. So we'll open that up and then go to right-click new folder. And we can create a new folder here. And I'll create one for my user. And then within there, we'll create a new text file. And we'll just put hello world in there. And that saved. So let's go back to our Azure AD domain services system. And we can see all of that from here as well. So I hope that you've enjoyed looking at this brand new feature, how we can finally enable cross-forest trusts with Azure AD domain services and our other on-prem or Azure-based domains. And this is going to certainly help open up some of those use cases where we cannot use Azure AD Connect, as well as if we have other security precautions in the environment like privileged access workstations, smart cards, or USB-based MFA tokens, etc. And we can leverage that trust to help us get things done in the cloud. So if you thought that this was a good video, please do click on the subscribe button and join us here at the Azure Academy. And while you're down there, click on that like button as well as the notification icon so you can get an email when our videos come out, which is roughly once a week. And this video was requested by one of the members of our community. So if you have a request for a video that you would like to see made, please do give us some comments down below on what you'd like and how that would benefit the community. And we'll be happy to make that video for you. So thanks very much for joining us today, and we will see you in the next video. Happy learning.